universe conspiring on our behalf if we let it.
I ran out of cold brew this morning. I'm just drinking regular, like, drip coffee. It gives me a crazy caffeine rush. Crazier than the cold brew. Anyways, we're here to talk about how being alone is probably one of the scariest things on earth. I've been on a long journey with aloneness. I'm an only child, so I was kind of born into the world, just me, myself, and I. I have also gone through many phases where being alone was the last thing on earth I would ever want to do. And then there's also been times where I probably spent an unhealthy amount of time alone. Being alone is very demure, very mindful. People who know how to be alone are never doing too much. Very enjoyable to be around. They're very pleasant to others. They're better in their relationships because they can handle themselves in healthy ways. Healthy, mindful, demure. Today is an exciting day. We finally are gonna get to do our strawberry matcha. I have cut up, how do I show you? These strawberries, delicious. I am going to make homemade strawberry simple syrup, which is actually pretty easy. Ta-da. I think this is the only step. I'm gonna add some syrup to cook it down with. I'm gonna make my matcha as normal. Hopefully it turns out good. I'm really excited. What could go wrong, truly? I do need a strainer though. We're giving Nara Smith. We're giving very crafty, very frugal. Okay, we make things at home that we could spend $10 to $15 on elsewhere. Very mindful. I actually need to be mindful that these don't burn, so. Wish me luck. Time. I took myself to the park. I'm sitting by the water. There's a big scary heron bird staring at me. I'm feeling a little threatened. He's right there. You see him? Right there? He is definitely eyeing me in a way that's making me very uncomfortable, but I'm just gonna try and ignore that. Oh my god. Oh. He flew away. I brought a little snacky snack that I half ate already. I also brought my book, which is sitting underneath my laptop right now. I'm just gonna chill here for a while. Reflect. There's no better place to reflect than in front of water. It's just so calming, peaceful. Welcome back to another Pinterest drawing sesh. The end of last video, we didn't get very far with that one, but that's okay. Should we go back to it? I think my favorite one we've done so far though is this one. I love this one. Let's revisit this one that I started last week. I feel like there's a lot we could add. First, I have to find my pencil. This will do. Perfect. Ugh, I don't know how to make these characters cute. Like, whenever I draw their faces, it's creepy. Look at the bottom one. That is scary. Now that I'm doing this again, I remember that this is why I gave up last time, because they're just not... Okay, they're not working. Whatever, I'm not gonna give up. This video comes at a time, well, kind of at the culmination of my solo journey. So I guess lately I've just been feeling very thankful to myself that I chose alone time as a way to cope with a lot of what I was dealing with. Because in the past, I don't think I had done that very well. I think I panicked at the thought of being alone, and that led me... It led me to putting myself in situations that probably I would have never otherwise been in.
I spent the last year probably more isolated than I've ever been in my whole life. I just felt this overwhelming compulsion to totally just start fresh, like blank slate myself in a way. Maybe with time, it will make more sense as to why that was the method I felt like taking, because even as I was choosing to do it, it didn't feel like it made a lot of sense to me, just because it was so out of character for the way that I had typically understood myself to be beforehand. I felt like I was a very almost like codependent person. Me not wanting to be around anybody, like actually being a little bit repulsed by the presence of other people, it was just a feeling that I had and I couldn't quite get rid of. The only option I had was to just go with it. Maybe it could be a good thing for me to just take some complete alone time and just face all of the difficult emotions that come with that. Because I recognized that I was using the presence of other people a lot of times to escape whatever I did not want to face. This also is probably just a big side effect of my frontal lobe developing, honestly, because it's natural to be around people and it's natural, especially as a teenager and young adult, to focus a lot of your time and energy on your social relationships. I'm scared because I'm not testing these colors before I'm just going straight in. So hopefully this comes out fine. Ooh, perfect. Perfect. This color is exactly what I thought it would be. I made a really conscious effort to spend literally every weekend by myself. It brought up so much intensity, like intense emotions. I don't think I've ever cried so much in my life. Every single time after I would get done crying, I would just feel the most crazy release. A, I had faced something that had been really difficult to face, and B, it didn't feel so heavy anymore. Like, I began noticing that I was becoming more and more confident in my ability to connect with other people, knowing that it was now coming from a place of authentic connection and less of a place of insecurity and desperation and maybe like a sense of scarcity. I think it's also important to say that I really felt a lot of panic from being alone when I first started out, even though it's something that I wanted to do so badly. That doesn't mean that I automatically loved it at first. I had to confront the strange and confusing sense of danger that I felt like I was in from being alone. And it was kind of like exposure therapy in a way. Once I faced that a couple times, I stopped being so panicky about it, started to feel so at peace in my own company. And I probably will never be in a position to do that again. I'm just reflecting on the version of me who faced a very big fear of hers. So thank you, self. Everyone hug yourself and thank yourself. I'm so serious. Everyone pat your own back and tell yourself something you're thankful for yourself doing. And say thank you, self. You're the best. I hate to admit that this drawing is just getting worse and worse. This is so stupid. The only thing I know how to do when things go this badly is just to add lines. Lines on lines on lines on lines. That's what I'm gonna do. They're so scary. I thought they would be cute. It's raining today. Not much going on. Something that I love to do alone is eat in my car. Turn on a podcast, just listen to music, and car time on a rainy day hits so much better. That's really what I want to do today. The past couple times I've attempted this activity, epic fails. Terrible. Couldn't have gone worse. And normally I do this activity as like a mood booster. Normally I'm not in my highest spirits. We're already a little down. So when it goes wrong, it's really sensitive. Can I take an extra hit if this goes south? Some days the answer is quite honestly no. Today I feel like I can handle a hit, however, if it goes bad, but I don't think it will because I really want to get this week's crumble cookies. Notice how they make a mini box. Perfect for personal size. Very demure. Very mindful. This is just so classy. Ooh, I'm excited. This one is chocolate strawberry or chocolate covered strawberry, served chilled. Delicious. It's a little bit dry, I think only because it's cold. Okay, next caller. Lemon glaze. Very mild lemon. Thought it would be stronger. Delicious nonetheless. Okay, now. I think this one is like the star of the show. This one is waffle. It comes with a thing of syrup. I think the best method of action is to open the syrup and then dip the cookie, fry style, into the syrup. Okay, I got my dip. Oh, wow. It quite literally tastes like a waffle. That might be the best one. So I'm gonna sit here, listen to a podcast. Hopefully both sides of my car are clear, so nothing worse than being watched on your car time. Okay, bye.
solution. It is being as fearless as one can and behaving as beautifully as one can under completely impossible circumstances.
The end is near, my friends, because we are snuggled up in bed like two little bugs in a rug, you and me. I tend to be sometimes a little bit of an extreme person. When I get very passionate about something, I take it to the extremes. I don't think that everyone's journey being alone needs to be quite as extreme as I took mine, because there is a balance, and humans are not meant to be alone. We are social creatures. We love to be around each other. All that to say, that's a very, very demure quality and a very mindful lesson to learn. It makes you so much stronger in a sense that you are so stable and grounded in your own being. You'll be at peace knowing that everyone in your life is there because they truly benefit you and make you feel at peace, because the peace that you get from conquering alone time is unmatched. You know that you have a special connection with people who make you feel even more at peace than you would if you were by yourself. I hope that this made things a little bit less scary. I'm just saying goodbye to my little solo sabbatical. I had a lot of fun. It's time to have more fun and learn new things. Okay, I'm really tired, so I'm gonna go to sleep. You can stay if you want. I'll make a space for you right here. And you can pick your stuffed animal, pink elephant or brown bear. Let me know. Okay, good night.